Oh my goodness, Amanda. I gotta go over this with you. Okay, so the girl in this story, the main character here's name is Amanda, and the other name, main character is Larry. Right, okay, just listen to this. Last week, a judge sentenced a West Virginia woman to 40 years in prison after she pleaded guilty to killing her boyfriend in 2019 with assistance from her biological father, who she then married. Hold on. No, I'll save it for the end. Local reports from station confirmed that Amanda, 31, was sentenced Thursday for a role in the February 19 murder of her boyfriend. She had been dating her boyfriend while they were both living in Minnesota. His dismembered body was discovered in September of 2019 in West Virginia. She pleaded guilty to second-degree murder in July, a month before her sex offender father, Larry, was sentenced to life without mercy for McGuire's killing. That must be a West Virginia way of saying life without parole. Larry was from Kentucky, was living in West Virginia after being released from prison, where he served time for sex offense charges. No specificity as to what those were. Amanda was estranged from her father. She was raised by her adoptive parents. The pair later became involved in an incestuous relationship and married in Virginia nearly a month after the murder. Dude, what am I gonna call this video? Fucking white people. I mean, dude, this seriously. If you had a fucking article about black people killing each other, I don't know, crack, watermelon, fried chicken. I'm not sure how many stereotypes you could fit into one story about black people. Rape or robbery. But dude, this is like the white person equivalent. This is hilarious. I hope all you black people are enjoying this, because it gets even fucking goofier. During last week's hearing, Amanda said that her boyfriend was killed because he was with me and my dad didn't want anyone else near me. She told the court that her boyfriend was killed not long after telling Larry, her daddy, he was in love with Amanda and wanted to marry her. So the father declares to the boyfriend, listen, I know you're dating my daughter, but I'm in love with my daughter and I want to marry her, so you're going to have to go. I wish I could bring my boyfriend back, a man said Thursday. He was a good man. According to reports, Larry drove to Indiana with Amanda's sister Anna, so now Anna's involved too, to pick up the boyfriend. The four, Amanda, her sister, and her daddy, Larry, and Amanda's boyfriend, Larry, drove to this place in West Virginia where they stayed for 10 days, but Larry confessed to hitting the boyfriend in the head with a bottle of wine on Valentine's Day. Aww, he really was in love. He was tied up. Okay, enjoy this, black people. He was tied up, injected with liquid methamphetamine, and later strangled with a garbage bag. Larry had previously testified that the boyfriend was tortured over 2 days before he died. The body was buried, dug up 6 days later. Boyfriend's body was dismembered before being buried again. Oh my God. This is just a stereotype. You couldn't write a stereotype better than this. Amanda's sister Anna is now also facing first-degree murder charges in connection with the boyfriend's death. Is it she's still awaiting trial? Oh, wait. There is a little more. The judge called the killing a heinous crime that lasted for 2 days and said Amanda was attempted to place all the blame for the death on her father. I don't think you're taking full responsibility for killing your boyfriend. You're blaming it on your father. After killing your boyfriend, you dug him up. When you all dug him up, his body was dismembered and stakes of some kind were driven through his body. Then you reburied him. There was no reason for this. Oh, this poor judge. The judge bemoaned the fact Amanda would likely only serve 20 years of her sentence. I hope and pray you will learn and change. And when you do get out, you'll be a different person. The time you will serve is not an adequate amount of time for the pain you've caused. Judge, I gotta say, man, nobody likes a mistrial due to insanity, but there's some fucking insanity there. Anyways, that was just a little pick-me-up story. I don't want anybody to ever say I'm biased, and I don't fucking shoot shit at both sides, so that was a total fucking cracker story, all right? just about every fucking white stereotype you could possibly have, every hillbilly fucking cracker stereotype you could have was in there. So, all right, that's it.